Thank you, Sri Jairam Ramesh.
I rise to speak very briefly on the International Financial Services Centres Authority Bill, which seeks to set up an integrated financial regulator for international financial centres. Sir, right now in India, we have only one international financial centre that is going to be regulated by this bill. This bill is to create a regulator for the much-wanted, grandiose project called GIFT, the Gujarat International Financial High-Tech City. The GIFT city was set up under the SEZ Act of 2005, and it is part of a dream of the then Chief Minister of Gujarat to create a Singapore or a Dubai on the Sabarmati. Many more such centers may undoubtedly come up, but as of now, this regulator that will come into being after the bill is passed is meant to regulate economic and commercial activities in GIFT City, which is about 8 kilometers from Gandhinagar. So I would like to ask the Honorable Finance Minister, GIFT was launched with great fanfare, and it was expected that when fully developed over a period of a decade, about 62 million square feet of commercial space would become available for investors, both domestic and international. However, sir, after almost 9 years of existence, out of 62 million square feet, according to the information that I've been able to get, up to now, less than 3 million square feet of commercial property has actually been developed. Now, this is an abysmal rate of progress. And obviously, sir, the ambition with which GIFT was created has yet to be fulfilled. I hope it will be fulfilled, but at the end of 9 years, it cannot be said that GIFT is a success story. In fact, in the last 1 year, GIFT has been in the center of a controversy because its joint venture partner, ILNFS, went completely bankrupt and created a ripple effect in India's NBFC sector, one consequence of which has been the dramatic continuing economic slowdown. However, it is coming out of that controversy, and one can only wish GIFT all the very best, but I do wish to make the point that this bill right now is going to create one authority for one person, for one agency, for one entity. Hopefully, there will be more such entities that will get created. But as of now, this is a gift for GIFT, to use your language, sir. Sir, one or two other questions I want to ask the Honorable Finance Minister. In an international financial center, will the rupee be completely convertible? Right now, the rupee is convertible on the trade account. But rupee, we do not have full capital account convertibility. However, if the ambition is to create Singapore's and Dubai's in India, and I would like the Honorable Finance Minister to share with us whether there are in fact similar proposals to develop Singapore and Dubai's in India like GIFT City, what does it do to capital account convertibility of the Indian rupee? Will the rupee be capital account convertible in these enclaves? So Singapore and Dubai are not enclaves. They are city-states. However, this SEZ Act 2005 creates enclaves within the larger territory of India, and one should be very clear what is permissible in the enclave and what is not permissible in the enclave. So in the expectation that ultimately this regulator will regulate international financial centers, I would seeking this clarification from the minister. Finally, sir, this regulator is going to take over functions of the RBI. It is going to take over functions of...